angle mode sits the top of the SWC switch, and then horizon, and then rate mode. But I've got motor stop on also. Now, first thing I noticed is the rates in the quick hover inside, angle mode and horizon mode, extremely fast, really fast. But in proportion to the rate mode, like that's angle. It's pretty perky. That's horizon, equally perky. And then you stick it in air mode, and it's quite sedate. I mean, not bad, but relatively sedate. So I think that's Super Expo doing its thing. Now this came with the green lights on the right and the red on the left. So swap that straight round. Red in the back, green on the front. This is really smooth. Sounds like I need to balance my props a little bit, but in terms of how it flies, wow. For a ready to fly? And this is 3S. So yeah, this Super Expo definitely, it deadens it up something rotten around center, so you've got way, way more stick. Normally I'd have maybe 40-50% stick before it starts getting really violent. I like a little Expo in the middle. This is like, you've got 50-60% of the stick before it even starts getting aggressive, and then it gets really, really aggressive. But that enables a lot of stick resolution for your basic moves, which means a lot of finesse, really. As long as you don't mind moving the stick a little bit further. I mean, it feathers the throttle back on beautifully. Now, I increased the yaw, because that was way too slow for me. I like the yaw to at least be similar to the cyclic, otherwise I feel I've got to move really small amounts on my yaw while I'm making huge cyclic movements, and it just doesn't feel right to me. It's not how I used to fly or enjoy. This is delightful. On 3S as well. Wow, rather impressed. Okay, there's no heat at all in those ESCs. can feel a tiny bit of warmth in the motors. I'm not concerned at all about that. You can thrash the hell out of it on 3S, no worries. We'll see if it'll hold up to 4S, but first let's try some FPV.
Up until, up until, up until, up until.
Okay, so rate mode. So there's a bit more speed on 4S. Not a huge amount, but there is more speed on 4S. And obviously, but a bit more torque. Noticeably more torque. for things like funnels, that torque is absolutely essential. Certainly like this. You can do basic funnels on 3S, but you're limited with your trajectory once you get it a certain height from the ground. Camera's super narrow, which is fine for racing, but I'm not used to that at all. It means that your tilt amount is really, it's like super important. Because your wide means up as well. Because I've stuck it at like 30 degrees, which is about right for me with most, even wide cams I could fly like that. But it felt, when I got it like in line for a gear, I had to sort of slow down to keep everything in shot a little bit, and I was like, oh. So I tried it at 45 degrees, thinking, that's just pretty aggressive for me, like, you can't really see the floor, you can't see the floor. And it wasn't enough. It felt like I'd still slow down as I was coming to gear. So I was looking up about 55 degrees, and I could still put some more on it, I reckon. But obviously when you take off, you're like, that, you have to tilt forward like what feels like 45 degrees before you go, oh, there's a bit of floor there. Yeah, I'm going to try the opposite rotation on then, see if it's just one rotation or not. Yeah, the ones that don't catch on that side do catch on this side. The left-hand, or right-hand rotation on the left-hand side doesn't catch, but moved across to the right-hand side, it does catch. So there's something slightly unsymmetrical going on. Is that way, just like 1 degree or something?
No,
this other one wasn't. There was this one of these boxes slightly loose, yeah.
They'll be moving then.